Hello and welcome to another set of World of Tanks replays. Again, I will be looking at some Stronghold replays, but what I will be looking at in this game, or these two replays, will be something you can use in a random battle as well. It is more specifically how to do defensive scouting, so to speak. And I'll be driving my T-54 lightweight. It's in a T-8 Stronghold for obvious reasons. And I'll be showing you how you can do some spotting that allows your team to defend their cap easily. Slight spoiler warning. But the first game here is on El Halouf. We are playing against 9TD3, which is the third clan in the 9TD community. So because it's not the 9TD community, I was expecting a good fight, because they have good field commanders in the main clan and second clan. And the first thing I do here in my T-54 lightweight, I'll just pause, is to drive to this position here. You can see I'm completely hidden, so I can spot everything down here. As you can see, I have full spot down here. I don't have the the gun depression to shoot if they move underneath me, but I have depression so I can shoot at these guys. And even though I'm out in the open, I'm too far away from that position over there to be spotted unless I fire. And if I fire, this bush here is gone anyway, so I'll be spotted. But this position here is really good if you don't want to commit to going down, because here I can spot what they have and fall back around the corner if needed without being in the danger. And as you will see here in a second, I can also take a shot into 3090 and just fall back immediately. And while I'm just scouting here, our team is securing the north. I got shot by 112 heat, which was a bit annoying, but what can you do? I'll do some more spotting. I think that was not necessarily my spot, but the 3090 we have in the middle. But as you can see, I'm just moving up and down a bit just to see what they have. And then I now notice that the Type 59 and Panther are moving around where I can't shoot them. So I decide now is the time for me to get out of here. So while I'm doing this, I was telling my team they need to clear the north and then send two mediums back to defend. Because now, as you can see on the minimap as well, a T-34-3 is coming back. So they have a 3090, Type, Panther and T-34-3 coming into our base. And sorry about the plinging in the background, that's my phone. But they are now pushing into our base, so I'm just telling them to come back. And because I'm all the way over here, I let the main force to be commanded by someone else. Gary in this situation, okay. Gary Ray, whatever his name is. We just call him Gary. And then I sit here and I do some spotting just to see if they were pushing up, which they were, and now I'm moving into a position that is quite strong. And it, for defensive purposes, like, it's not necessarily the best position ever. I'm a bit lucky here. I should have, if I'd been unlucky, I would have taken a shot passing through that little gap. But I drive up here, because what the enemy might like to do also in a random battle is to send a light tank up this side on this mountain here and spot your base, as you can see here. Like, they have perfect shots into your base from up here. So I drive up here to make sure that they can't use this position. And lo and behold, I meet a 3090, I track him. And, like, I don't have the best gun depression, but neither does he. So it's okay. So now you can see we are two types, and me holding back 1, 2, 3, 4 tanks. He's trying to push over. We both try to shoot each other. I auto aim. I should have manually aimed that one, which I do now. And as you can see, I can sneak shot into his cupola, and oh, he doesn't like that anymore. But now he's like, I'm making sure he can't shoot down to our types, and our types are making sure that they don't push out. So I'm just sitting, and I'm like, okay, now the 3090 has been scared off. And again, as you can see in the minimap, while this is going on, our team is pushing into their base. But we have a significant advantage in health for pushing into their base, so that's quite decent. So here I'm just spotting, just being present, showing that I'm here. Just making sure this 3090 doesn't unload into anyone. So just, as you can see, I'm denying them to push through and I can spot. As you can see in the second, I'll spot for our team. And I have shots down on these guys here. Which put some... like, they can't use it to those positions because I'll shoot down on them. Because as you can see, my tank is tilted. So I have quite good gun depression, even though it's only a Russian tank. And now we are communicating with the heavy force pushing in, and they're saying that they are being shot from our side. So I start to work that a bit better. Slowly anyway. Here we go. So the type is now there. I auto-aim because then I can just go over. But I decided not to auto-aim because I noticed the auto-aim was on the turret, which is the strong bit. So now we are keeping all of these guys occupied. So basically, we're using 3 tanks to lock down 4 tanks, which is... ideally you would use fewer tanks, and we could have maybe done with only 1 tank. But it's working quite well. And being up here in your scout tank is always quite nice. Here my reload is just too long for me to blab the 3090. And here you can see that they are now shooting across. Here auto aim and hit his turret. 3090 now shoots me once and I can't get a shot back. And we order now our types to push into these guys so we can clear off. Like, our heavy force said that they were holding on, so it was not a problem. So, I mean, we weren't in a big rush, we just said, okay, let's just clean up. What I did there was to scare the 3090 away, because now I can sit here in peace and quiet without him going up my bum. So I take the type out. The 88 is sitting there. And now it's just cleaning up. Like, now we are cleaning up. So this shows you how nice this position can be here. Kill the Panther. I decide to go down. And he dies. Like, so that does nothing. I could have repaired the tracks there, but I was like, the game was done, so I didn't want to waste a repair kit or nothing. So if I died from that T-34 flea, I would have died, and so be it. And as you can see now, our heavies are cleaning up, so I'll just fast forward that. And now the TD guys are nice enough to say, well played. And then we say thank you and a good attempt to them. Like, I could see what they were trying to do, it just didn't work. But yeah, so now you know that position when you're defending the north base. And now we're just cleaning up. So there we go. That's the first game. I'll show you some post-game stats and then you can... let us just jump straight into the next battle. So yeah, I'll see you in a bit. Hello, and here we have the second replay. This time it's still a tier 8, slightly different team composition as you can see. We're playing on Abbey, and we are playing against the Atlas clan, that I don't know, so I don't know what to expect from them, but the usual thing I do on Abbey is to send the main force down the 1-2 line, and then a scout out on the 8 line to spot, which, since I'm in my T-54 and had a good spawn, I would do that. They have two JP2s, so I was a bit... I was considering whether or not they would base camp or not. But I sent a scout over here, and this bush here, again, works brilliantly in random battles as well, because you can spot, as you'll see in a second, a lot of tanks moving down this little... yeah, coastal road, I don't know what you want to call it. But as you can see on the minimap, all of our heavies are just moving up on the balcony. Like, I told them to just wait. And there we go. I spotted one IS-3, two IS-3s. And I decided, yep, that's all of them. I think I spotted three in the end. Yeah, three IS-3s. I'm like, okay, everyone. And now you can see I'm beginning to ping the map. I'm just saying they're coming down the 8th line. Everyone just stay on the balcony to shoot into our base. We'll shoot them as they come in. Mediums clear down the 1-2 line. Because if they have three IS-3s coming down the 8th line, it means that our mediums should be able to overwhelm the other three IS-3s that might be sitting on the 1-2 line. And then I drive into another great defensive scouting position for the south base and Abbey. It's up here. Not a lot of people know about this. It's quite easy to get up here, as you can see. And then you simply just knock down this tree. Well, you don't have to. And then you just sit here. I have a perfect spot to the entrance to our base, and they can just... I mean, I can wreck them from here. So we'll speed it up a bit. Here comes the IS-3s, because this position here is not anything spectacular. I'm just... You can see, I spot the IS-3s, they're like, oh shit, what's going on? All of them are here, they're moving around, trying to not be spotted, but they're perma-spotted by me sitting here. So I just sit here and just wait. I tell the mediums to just clear out the base, they should be able to deal with two JPs. And I stay here and I just get a lot of spotting damage. Some of the ISs, they went down the low road and are now trying to come up that way. And you can see our gun battery sitting up here, just shooting. They have no clue what's going on, these ISs, they can't spot back. And now, okay, I'll actually... What's going on now is just that the camp was a bit too close to comfort, so I can... From this position, you can drive over here, jump over, and shoot a target. So I shoot the one with the front, and I pull back. And now I sit here where they can see me, and I can see them. And I just start to abuse my armor. Like, the shot that they have is that. And like, they have a sliver of my lower plate they can hit if they're really, really lucky. But most of it, as you can see, will hit the upper plate, especially if I wiggle. Like I am here, you can see I'm wiggling. So, I mean, this position here is not anything spectacular, but it just shows you you can completely nullify, push into your base. And here I'm like, guys, come on, we have a... Like, I don't like it when the cap gets above 50%, but now it's fine, so I just told them, you can clean up now if you want to. Which we do. So, I mean, that's... As you can see, it was... That, especially the spotting position out here on the 8th line is really, really good for random battles, because you just fall back and then you can sit here if you need to spot the base. Like, in randoms, this position here is not that common to use, because people will just either push you or push away. But in organized play, it's amazing. And now I just push in and clean up. So as you can see, this one here is not anything spectacular. This last position, like, it doesn't require a lot, just sit. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed these two defensive scouting positions, and hopefully you learned something for random battles. And yeah, again, if you have any comments or questions, feel free to leave them down below. And this video was a bit shorter, or a bit more, not as advanced as some of my other things, but I thought it was worth sharing, because not a lot of people know about those two positions, the one on El Haluf and the one on Abbey South Spawn. Are quite fun. The one on El Haluf you can use as an offensively as well, whereas the one here on Abbey is mainly a defensive position, because you can't really shoot onto the balcony that easily. You can, but it's difficult, so is predominantly a defensive position to sit. In the epic game, by the way, I ended up getting 4,000 spotting damage from 6 IS-3s, which is a significant portion of their health. So that's that was good. But anyway, yeah, as always, if you have any comments or questions, feel free to ask away. And if not, then hopefully I'll see you on the battlefield. And if I don't, then yeah, hopefully for my next video, whenever that'll be, whenever I have another interesting stronghold or random battle to show you. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.